Hello everyone, we continue our chess videos. I prepared some new topic in my chess channel. This is about beautiful chess games. In future we will watch some interesting games, and I like when the game is interesting, nice and short. Maybe something like chess miniatures. This game was played between Cebalo Miša, Croatian Grandmaster, and Vasyukov Evgeny, Russian Grandmaster. It was played in Šibenik 2014, some senior team championships. And okay, we will see. It was so amazing game. Cebalo was white and he started game with pawn d4. And Vasyukov played f5. He wants to play Dutch defense. And now white has many different ways how to play. And Miša, he played bishop g5. This is some interesting move, like a Trompowski opening or some queen pawn game with bishop f4, bishop g5. I played when I was young a lot, and here is interesting how black will continue. Black in this game he played g6, but here is some interesting way for black. Maybe black can choose knight f6, but this is maybe not the best way because it's allow white to capture on f6 and then to play some kind of this position, and this is typical Trompowski position where white made double pawns in black position, and I don't like, and the f6 square is occupied. The black knight cannot jump to f6. I think this is not the best way. But another way for black is h6. Here we have some interesting option, bishop h4 and then g5. And it looks like black will trap this bishop and black will win the bishop, but it's not like this. First, white can play e3, and then threat is to give queen h5 to give checkmate, because black king is just open this diagonal, and black doesn't have time to win the bishop. Then black can continue something like this, and then bishop g3, and white save this bishop. But there is another alternative for white, bishop g3, and now many chess players just wanted to try to trap this bishop, but this is not the best way. It looks that black will win the piece, but black has to think about his king. This is very important, because now in this position, if white wants to give checkmate, this is like in previous what I said, then this king is in big dangerous, because this diagonal, then black has to think how to protect this, maybe h5, and then he wants also to win this bishop on g3, but white has just easy bishop e2. Give up the bishop, but bishop h5 is checkmate. And he wants to win h5 and then f4. After knight here, then capture. And now maybe only way to try something for black to win this bishop. But then white has this move. And after capture, then white can recapture with pawn. And we can see that there is knight hanging, and when this knight moved, then there is another way just to give a checkmate, because king is open, and this is not the best option. But here is interesting, after e3, then black can play maybe e5, he made a way for king to go king e7, and then, white bishop is in trap, where to go with this bishop on g3? This is interesting. But then we will not lose the bishop. This is very important because white has this move, and after pawn capture, then white has check. It's very important. And after king e7, sacrifice this bishop, and after pawn capture, then queen e5 gives check, and then attack the rook. This is double attack, and white will win exchange. But the black king is in a very dangerous position, and we can see here that this red is going up. It means that white has big material advantage. Okay, but this is some interesting that we can see how opening is going. But in this position, Vasyukov played g6 and then e3. And now how to continue with black? This is also a question, because knight f6, we said that white will capture to f6. Black played, according to engine Stockfish, maybe the best move, knight h6, with idea knight goes to f7, because in this position is very famous that white will start attacking with h4, h5. This is some idea for white, and to capture here and to make pressure on h5 or something like this. But for example, here, if this move is okay, but there is another move, bishop g7, we can see that white can continue knight c3, and he can quickly develop his pieces, and after knight f6, then h4, with idea h5. For example, now if black is doing h6, then we can capture here, and then g4, and here white has big advantage, because white will quickly develop pieces, make long castle, and then black king is not so good. It's so open position on the king side, it will be some weakness around there. And here maybe black can play d5, but then h5 is a great. This is so famous in the Dutch defense, when white sacrifice exchange, rook h5. And after winning this changing, okay, this is exchange down for white. Black moved the king, and then white has big compensation. According to computer say, engine say about plus one or more for white. But okay, it's not easy with black to play this position. White has great compensation, but is it plus one or plus 0.50? I don't know. Okay, white is fine here. We are going back to see our interesting game. Knight h6. h4, white played. Then knight f7. And here, bishop f4, because knight attacked the bishop, and white wants to play forward later with this pawn h5. D6, h5 doesn't go because black has g5. But after knight f3, now maybe white can do h5. Also, black idea was in some moment just to play e5. And this move knight f3 is good to make control of this square, then black cannot play d5. This is very important. And now black is doing knight d7, and he also he wants to play e5 to attack this bishop and to develop more pieces, and it's okay. But now white is playing bishop c4, and here black cannot do this what he wants to do, e5, because he will lose this pawn in this way: knight, bishop f7, king capture, and d e5, and white is with pawn up. It's not good for black, and in this position black did bishop g7. He wants to make maybe castle or to play e5. Now he has more control on e5 square, but white is doing nice move, bishop f7, give pair of bishop, but after this move white has knight g5, and maybe black played fast, or I don't know, but black overlook this move, because now king cannot go down because of knight e6. For example, king g8, then knight e6, attack the queen, queen here, knight c7 here, and just capture the rook, and white has rook more. Okay, white will lose this knight on a8, but it will be exchange more for white. And here only move for black is just to play king f6, like he did. White continue very nice, knight c3 with idea knight d5 checkmate. It's so amazing. If, for example, black is playing h6 to attack the knight, then knight d5 is checkmate. Now we can see that black king doesn't have where to go. And because of this square where white knight wants to jump, then black is playing c6 and protect this square. Now white is playing queen f3. Very good move. The best position for white queen. And just to make some Rengen here, this is some kind of pin that this king will be later in trouble, because queen is on f file. This is also important, but also developing move and make castle, but many different ideas. It's depend here what black will do. Black played e5, but here is interesting. For example, if black is doing h6 to attack the knight, it looks like a normal move, but then white has bishop e5, check, and after this, or knight capture, it's the same, knight to e4, and it's checkmate. Black king doesn't have where to go, because two knights, they control everything. This another knight control this two squares, and black king is in checkmate. It's so nice. And because of this, black played e5 and wants to attack the bishop and to try to play some another move. King can go to e7. This is very important. But now white to move, white play and have excellent move. This is queen d5, and Misha Tsebalo played this. This is excellent game about from Misha Tsebalo. It's so amazing how to beat very strong grandmaster, Russian grandmaster. He beat in 13 moves. This is move 12, queen d5, and here it's nice threat is queen e6 checkmate, or queen f7 checkmate, or queen d6 checkmate, because now it's a big problem about black king where to go. For example, on cd5, this is so amazing, knight d5 checkmate. Or on ef4, then queen can give many kind of checkmates, but this one is just enough, queen f7. And after this, black has to defend all this threat, and then black played queen e7 to defend. Now white cannot give checkmates, but now it's so amazing, white played knight h7 check, and black resigned the game, because only move is just to capture with rook, and then is going bishop to g5. It's so nice. This game is excellent played by Ceballo, and I like this game, and I hope you will like also this game, and maybe you can play this, you can put in your repertoire d4, f5, bishop, g5. It's excellent move. Thank you very much. See you next time with my some next game. Until this, bye-bye.